Everyone, my name is Josephy again, and today I am going to discuss about enzyme inhibitors. So we have the introduction, importance of enzyme inhibition, what are the types of enzyme inhibitors. So in enzyme inhibitors we have mainly two types, one is reversible, another one is irreversible. For reversible we have competitive, non-competitive and uncompetitive. And in case of irreversible, we have the active site directed and suicide inhibitors. So after that, we are going to discuss some about the Michaelis-Menten equation and the references where I have collected the data. So for introduction part, we have the any chemical entity or compound which either critically retards or specially blocks the phenomenon of enzyme catalysis. So inhibitors are the chemicals that reduce the rate of enzymatic reactions. They block the enzyme but they do not usually destroy it. So inhibitors are the compound which inhibit the binding of enzyme and substrate to produce the product. It inhibits the binding site of the enzyme, which ultimately inhibit the binding the substrate. So next we have the importance of the enzyme inhibition. For understanding the regulation of enzyme activity within the living cells, so this is the importance of enzyme inhibition. So to elucidate the kinetic mechanism of an enzyme catalyzing in a multi-substrate reaction, so useful in elucidating the cellular metabolic pathways by causing accumulation of intermediates, identification of the catalytic groups at the active site. What are the catalytic group which is present in the active site of the enzyme? So provide information about the substrate specificity of the enzyme. So these are the importance of the enzyme inhibition. So types. First we have the reversible inhibitors. So inhibitor bind to enzyme reversibly through a non-covalent interaction. So it is a inhibitor which bind to the enzyme's binding site reversibly through a non-covalent interaction. Okay? Non-covalent means weak bond. So an equilibrium is established between the free inhibitor or enzyme inhibitor complex and is defined by an equilibrium constant, which is Ki. So in the diagram you can see where enzyme is bind with the inhibitor can produce a enzyme inhibitor complex. The activity of enzyme is fully restored on removing the inhibitor by the dialysis. After binding the enzyme and inhibitor, which will form a enzyme inhibitor complex, but the enzyme can be fully restored by removing the inhibitor. So the bonded inhibitor we can remove by dialysis. So next we have the competitive inhibitors. In case of competitive inhibitor, what happens? A competitive inhibitor often has a structural features similar to those of the substrate whose reaction they inhibit. So suppose we have in diagram you can see we have a competitive inhibitor in the diagram which is coded as red and substrate as orange. So the enzyme have the binding site which is like a triangle. So the substrate and competitive inhibitor both can bind in the enzyme's binding site. So it have the structural similarities, both the competitive inhibitor and the substrate. So this means that a competitive inhibitor and enzymes substrate are in direct competition for the same bindings active site on the enzyme. So we can remove this competitive inhibitor by increasing the concentration of the substrate. If the enzyme bind with the substrate, it will form enzyme substrate complex, ultimately it will form products. But if the enzyme bind with the competitive inhibitor, the enzyme will be inactive. The substrate cannot bind with the enzyme due to this competitive inhibitor. So like in example, we have sulfanilamide and PABA. This is para-aminobenzoic acid. The antibiotic sulfanilamide is similar in the structure to the PABA, para-aminobenzoic acid, and intermediate in the biosynthetic pathway for folic acid. Sulfanilamide can competitively inhibit the enzyme that has PABA as its normal substrate. Normal substrate is PABA, but sulfanilamide is having the structural similarity with the PABA. So it is a competitive inhibitor for PABA. So that you can see that sulfanilamide can competitively inhibit the enzyme that has a PABA as its normal substrate by the competitively occupying the active site of the enzyme. So sulfanilamide is similar in the structure to the PABA, that's why it is a competitive inhibitor for PABA. Non-competitive inhibitors, these are not influenced by the concentration of the substrate. It inhibits by binding irreversibly to the enzyme, but not at the active site. It is an allosteric. One site is there in the enzyme, which is called as allosteric site. So they also bind with the same affinity to the free enzyme and form the enzyme substrate complex. It changes the shape of the enzyme and active site. The site where where the inhibitor will bind in enzyme is called as allosteric site. After binding the inhibitor in the enzyme, it changes the binding site of the substrate in the enzyme. So ultimately, it blocks the substrate enzyme complex. For example, we have silver ions, that is heavy metal, react with the SH group of groups in the side group of cysteine residues in the protein chain. So we have the cysteine residue in the protein chain at the left. So if the cysteine residue is somewhere on the protein chain, which affects the way it falls into its tertiary structure, then altering this group could have an effect on the shape of the active site and so stop the enzyme from working. The next is uncompetitive inhibitor. In case of uncompetitive inhibitor, do not bind to the free enzyme. They bind only to the enzyme substrate complex to yield an inactive enzyme substrate inhibitor complex. In the diagram, you can see there is a different binding site for each. So uncompetitive inhibitor frequently observed in multi-substrate reaction. So inhibition cannot be reversed by increasing the substrate, since inhibitor does not compete with the substrate for the same binding site. Both the enzyme and inhibitor have their different binding site. So inhibitor and substrate bind to their respective binding site and form a EASI complex, which is enzyme substrate inhibitor complex. So next we have the irreversible inhibitor. Inhibitor bind at or near the active site of the enzyme irreversibly, usually by covalent bond, so it cannot be dissociated from the enzyme. Irreversible inhibitors combine with the functional groups of the amino acids in the active site irreversibly. So irreversible inhibitors occupy or destroy the active site of the enzyme permanently and decreases the reaction rate. And enzyme activity is not regained on dialysis. We cannot regain the enzyme activity by dialysis, which we can do in reversible inhibitor. So active site directed inhibitor. So active site directed inhibitor is also called as affinity level. It is a chemically reactive compound that is designed to resemble the substrate of an enzyme so that it binds at the active site and forms a stable covalent bond with a susceptible group of the nearby residue in the enzyme protein. So So these affinity levels are very useful for identifying catalytically important residues. So next we have suicide inhibitor. A suicide inhibitor is a relatively inert molecule that is transformed by an enzyme at its active site into a reactive compound that irreversibly inactivates the enzyme. So ultimately this suicide molecule, these molecules, these inert molecules cause irreversible inactivation of the enzyme. So they are the substrate analogs designed so that by a normal catalytic action of the enzyme, a very reactive group is generated. The latter forms a covalent bond with a narrower functional group within the active site of the enzyme, causing irreversible inhibition. So this is the function of suicide inhibitor. So next we have the Michaelis-Menten equation, where the Michaelis-Menten equation arises from the general equation for an enzymatic reaction. You can see this enzyme when bind with the substrate, which will form enzyme substrate complex, and ultimately it produces enzyme and product, which release the product. The both are reversible. The Michaelis-Menten equation is the V equal to Pmax substrate divided by Km plus substrate, where Vmax is the maximal rate of reaction, where S is the substrate concentration and Km is the Michaelis-Menten equation, where V means this is the velocity of the reaction. So these are the references. These are Arsatos Kaur, Berger Biochemistry, and Albert Ellenicke Biochemistry. This is for enzyme inhibitor. Thank you.